and they introduce the name, I can go through all the people's names. This is Tom. This is Edward. And this is Matthew. And this is Darren, where he is. Right. And here. And here. Harper, if you look really close. And the song's called, I'm a Baby, Baby, Oh Man.
No, it isn't!
And, well, I guess we can start now. I'm a baby, baby, blue. And in the playoffs, you have one playoff match, but it would be against somebody that you have not played. And in order to do that, we need all of us to play. So, like, we need Edward, Tom, and Matthew to play. And so, and then there would be...
Kevin?
A one game.
I think we'd like to
hear
other people talking.
And then we would have this 2-3 series sometimes. So, I'll let him talk a little bit.
Hello, everybody. How are you?
What have you enjoyed most this week, Tom?
Playing basketball with Kevin.
Why is that?
No. I just like it.
You play basketball at home?
Not really.
Mm-hmm. Are you looking?
Are there basketball hoops at home? I mean, some near where you play with?
No, they're only at school. The nearest ones are at school, and we're not allowed into. So.
Why is that?
Because they're indoors.
Oh.
And people aren't allowed to.
Are you looking? Are you looking forward to going to Disney World for your vacation?
Yes.
Okay. You done?
Yeah, next, please.
Edward? Edward, what are you enjoying most on the trip?
Going sightseeing.
Oh, really? What sights have you liked the most?
Going to the FBI.
Oh, really? What was it about that was the best?
The guns.
When they shot the guns?
Yeah.
Are you looking forward to going on vacation to Disney World?
Yes.
Very much. Okay, you done?
Yeah.
This is Matthew.
Gun off, sorry, Mom.
Hello?
Hello?
Are you looking forward to going on vacation to Disney World?
Yes.
Yeah. Are you like going to see?
When it was pouring down rain?
Yeah.
That was fun, wasn't it?
Yeah.
We're all from England.
Yeah.
Okay, I think we should start the song now.
Okay, then.
Okay. You going to sing a song, Darren? The end?
you have ever seen a real live magician before? Raise your hands nice and high. That's good. Well, listen, there's just two things that I would like for you to know about my magic show. Number one, if I should say anything that's funny and you want to laugh, well, you go right ahead and do so, because right after the show, I've got to go home. It would be kind of odd or strange or a little bit peculiar if you went home tonight and in the middle of your sleep, you woke up and remembered something that I said that was funny and started to laugh. Well, I'll tell you, your mom and dad would think that you went bananas. You know what I mean? Also, if I should do anything that is super duper spectacular and you want to give me a great big round of applause, well, you go right ahead and do so, because I just love to hear people clap for me. In fact, how about a big round of applause for me right now? What a terrific audience we have out there. Fantastic. Hey, I've got a few questions I'd like to ask you. If you like to eat hot dogs, raise your hands nice and high. Put your hands down. If you like to eat cheeseburgers, raise your hands nice and high. Put your hands down. If you like popcorn, raise your hands nice and high. Put your hands down. If you like pizza, raise your hands nice and high. Put your hands down. If you like ice cream, raise your hands. Put your hands down. If you like candy, raise your hands. Put your hands down. If you've been bad today, oh, I got you. I got you. I even got her back there. Now, before we start off our magic show, I'm going to ask that you give me a magic awareness test. Now, this test will determine if I am good enough to be here today. You see, if I'm not good enough to be here, then I'm going to have to pack up all my gear and go on home. Yeah. First thing we need for this magic test is a magic ball. Where can I get me a magic ball? And pull it right out of here. Now, what I would like for you to do is to follow this ball, and I'm going to attempt to make the ball disappear before your very eyes. Watch carefully as I tuck the ball into my left hand. Tuck the ball into my right hand. Give both hands a shake, and the ball has disappeared before your eyes. Again, I'll tuck the ball into my left hand. Tuck the ball into my right hand. Give both hands a shake, and the ball is
still there. It's still there. It's still there. It's
still there. I don't know what I'm doing wrong, but whatever it is, it's just not working. Let me get some magic dust in my pocket. Sprinkle some magic dust on my ball, just like that. This time, I'm going to put the ball in my left hand, just like that. Put the ball into my right hand, just like that. Give both hands a shake, and without any doubt, the ball has disappeared. My right hand.
But you put it in your pocket.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's nothing in my pocket except some car keys.
No, my
your
coat
pocket.
Pocket.
Observant audience. No matter what I do, I can't seem to get that ball to disappear. But you know what? I want one last chance. Now, if I can't make this ball disappear on my last try, I'm going to make sure that each and every one of you get a year's gift certificate to Domino's Pizza.
Yeah!
However, if I can make this ball disappear on my last try, you've got to be special good to your parents next week. Watch carefully as I tuck the ball into my left hand, tuck the ball into my right hand, give both hands a shake, and without any doubt, the ball has finally disappeared. How many of you think the ball's in that hand? What you see is nothing more than a red square and a black ball. Mm-hmm. Thank you, thank you.
How do you like that, Mom?
It's Dawkinson. For a magic show, I need a volunteer from the audience. How about if we have the birthday girl? Yeah. Let's give her a big round of applause. Hello, my name is Lynn. And how old is Darren today?
Six.
6 years old. Hey, Darren, are you married?
No.
Darren, are you all set to help me with some magic? Now, what Darren volunteered to do, Darren volunteered to help me put some air into this balloon, and we want to penetrate it with a long, long silver spike. First thing you need to do is put some air in my balloon. Darren, you try blowing on the balloon one time. Go puff. You go puff. Can you go puff? Just go puff.
Hello, Darren.
Go like that. Oh, hey, Darren.
You opened it, not me.
Well, you blew on it. Now you take the fan. Now you start the fan and that towards in the air, but get your knees into it, Darren. Get your knees up and down and up and down. Don't stop. You gotta keep fanning. This feat of magic is not being brought to you by Lentilio, but by my able assistant, Darren. Let's all give Darren a big round of applause. Thank you, Darren. When I was about your age, I fell in love with bubblegum. I tell you, I used to spend all my allowance at the store buying bubblegum. But then I became a magician. And no more do I have to buy bubblegum. You see, now I make my special brand of bubblegum, which I call Funky Bubblegum. Well, it requires two people to make Funky Bubblegum, the magician and a volunteer from the audience. Do I have a volunteer from the audience? How about this young lady right here? Let's give her a big round of applause. Come on. All right. Hello. My name is Lennon. Your name?
Jamie.
Can I shake hands with you, Jamie? How old is Jamie?
Six.
You're sick? Let me feel your head. Oh, my.
six.
Oh, 6 years old. And I'm glad to meet you. Are you glad to meet me? What are you doing there? Well, anyway, we're going to need a couple pieces. Bubblegum. Get some sugar back here. Pour some sugar into your paper. Pour some into mine. Now, would you blow some magic into your paper? I'm going to take her paper and I'm going to mix it with my paper and attempt to blow the world's most unusual bubble. ears who can follow directions. How about if we have that young man over there, and how about we have this young lady? Let's give them both a big, big round of applause. Hello, my name is Len, and your name?
Nicole.
Nicole, how old are you, Nicole?
6.
6 years old, Nicole. Could you face the audience just like that? Hi, my name is Len. Your name?
Kevin.
Kevin, how old is Kevin?
8.
You're 8? Well, what grade are you in, Kevin?
3rd.
You're in the 3rd grade?
Yeah.
You know, when I was in the 3rd grade, my daddy used to walk me to school every day. See, he had no choice. He used to sit right behind me in class. You laugh at my jokes. You're a pretty good job, I tell you. Now, you come over here a little bit like this. I want to give you two directions test to see if you can follow directions. Raise your hand, right hand, nice and high. Put your right hand down. Left hand up in the air. Left hand down. Both hands up in the air. Both hands down. Now, one leg all the way like that. Don't put it down until I tell you to. Get it up there. I've got to tell the audience. The only way over here is to... Both hands out like that, yeah, wiggle your fingers. Both hands down. Now both feet up in the air. Whoa, 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 whoa! That is an impossible. Wait a minute now. Something's wrong. Where's your bow tie?
I took it away a couple years ago.
You were supposed to wear a bow tie to the show.
Oh, well.
Together. I want you to look at the soldier first. Put both feet together. Hands down by your side. Tuck in your tummy. Tuck in your tummy. Hands down by your side. Tuck in your tummy. Chest out, chin up. Hands down by your side. Get that tummy tucked in, chest out, chin up. What you think? Blue is his color? Yeah. I get a couple of blue soaps over here. Let me see how they're going to look before I tie them in a knot. I'm going to tie a double knot in these soaps. I learned how to tie these knots when I was in the Girl Scouts about 4 years. I joined the Girl Scouts because the girls are so much prettier to look at. Yeah. Hold on there. Hands down by your side. Hands down by your side. Tuck this in here. Oh.
Hi, Nicole.
Looky there, girl. Now, I tell you, isn't he the handsomest?
Yeah. No.
Don't move. Put your feet together. Hands down by your side. Tuck in your tummy, chest out, chin out, and smile on your face. Don't move. Don't move at all. What we're going to do, we're going to tie a couple other soaps, one on this end and one on that end, to make it give it some color. Now, you're going to help on this, and what I would like for you to do is put your hand out like this, nice and flat, and I'm going to put a soap on your hand, and I've got another soap, which is really multi-color. This has got a blue on the outside, orange, red on the inside. Select in just about a few... Whoa! bouncing up and down.
What
I would like for you to do is to hold on to my soap by the two top corners, just like that. And as you're doing that, I want to show the audience that I have a funny looking hat. It's a funny looking hat because it's got a handle on the end of it. Now I want you to hold the two top corners.
Yeah.
The bottom corners. See, these are two top corners.
How could you tell?
Well, they're the opposite from the bottom. And the bottom is opposite from the top. And you had the bottom and I wanted the top. There you go. Now, I'm going to take my funny looking hat. And I'm going like to
you can tell.
To drop the
yeah, it is a hat. It is a hat.
Now I'm going to give you a magic wand. And with my magic wand, she's going to pass it over my hat four times, and she's going to say the magic passages. I'm going to get my magic wand right here, just like this. You pass it over my hat just like that. Can you do that? Okay, hold on to nice and gentle. Now, we're going to... We don't want that to happen. We want you to hold it nice. Whoa. Okay, hold it nice and straight. Can you do that? Sure you can. Okay, you have it there. Now, we're going to get... Pass it over my hat and say one.
What?
No. say one.
What?
Come here. Say one.
What?
say one. Okay, we'll go by that then.
It's gone.
Say a dab a dab with me.
A dab a dab with me.
And a you do four.
And a you do four.
Yeah, let me have my magic wand back. Now there should be two silks, one for each end. Would you take out one of the silks? Just take out one, reach inside, get one of them out. Just one, leave the other one behind for now. Yeah, we'll put that one right on. Come over here. Let's check something out here. Let me see your finger. Ooh, you know why that soap disappeared? Because you got magic in those fingertips. You know what she just did?
What
I've been trying to do for the past 95 years. She made that soap disappear. But with my help, we're going to make it reappear in between the two blue silks. How about that? And... Thank you. Let's give our two volunteers a big round of applause. Thank you. I'm going to let you make a big decision today. It's a big one. We can have... one more magic routine, or we can have two more magic routines. We can have two if you give me a big round of applause. Two it is. I wanted to tell you a little bit about a hobby that I took up last summer. A hobby is where you do something to help pass the time away. Well, when I was in Florida about 11 months ago, I took up a hobby called magic painting. And you're supposed to paint these pictures using magic paint. When I bought the picture of the clown, it was supposed to come with some magic paint, but the store was all out of the magic paint. But they told me, they said, sir, if you drive up to Virginia, you'll be able to find some magic paint in Virginia. So I did just that. I traveled all over the state of Virginia to find me some magic paint. Couldn't find me none at all. But then I decided I'd drive over to Maryland. I looked all over the state of Maryland for some magic paint. Couldn't find me any there either. But then it dawned on me as I was driving over here today. Why not, I said. Since I'm doing a very special birthday party for Rachel.
Not Rachel, Darren.
Darren, for Darren and all her friends, I thought I would have you help paint my clown. I want to need all your help, but I also need the volunteers of two people. How about that young lady over there? And would you like to come on up? And let's give them both a big round of applause. Hello. My name is Len. Your name?
Jill.
And how old is Jill? How's Jack? How's Jack? Jack and Jill. Jill, can you hold on to this picture right up against your tummy? Hello, my name is Len, and your name? And how old is Megan?
6 years
old. Megan, can I take this off for a moment and I'll give it back to you? Can you just come off easy? Oh, I don't want to hurt yourself. Okay. I'll just put this back here. Now, you two are going to help paint that clown with the help of our audience. Now, what I would like you to do is to hold your hands out just like that. Here's where you come in handy, and you. I'm going to ask that you pretend to take off some colors. You're going to take off the colors. You're going to toss them up to me. I'm going to catch them. I'm going to get them. Oh, my. You have on such beautiful clothes, and clean at that. I'm afraid, Megan, if we get paint on your clothes, your mama be awfully mad at me. I'm going to have to get her an artist mark. Let me get one here. This will protect you real good. Just perfect size, too. Put your right hand in here. Yeah. Put your left hand in there. Let me button this up here. Hands down by the sides. Okay, button this up here real good. Let me roll up your sleeves, Megan. Ow! Oh, don't punch me in the nose! Ow! Gee whiz, get on this
hole. Uh-oh, her clothes are showing! Her clothes are showing, and that's mine!
Where's your hand at, Megan?
I'm not there!
You stay back. Where's your hand at? Oh, it's in here. I'll roll this up just a little bit. Okay. There we go. Put your hands out just like that. Here's where you come in handy. You're going to pretend to take off a color. Let's say about you're wearing blue. You pretend to take off the blue. You're going to toss it up to me. I'm going to catch it. And I'm going to get it. You know, we've got Megan's clothes all protected, but if we get paint in her hair, we'd be in a pickle. I gotta get her an artist hat. I got the perfect one, too. It's a genuine imitation Leonardo da Vinci painting. Put this right on top of Megan's head. Whoa! Sit there, Megan. Hey, Megan. When was the last time you had your eyeballs examined? That long. I'm afraid if you don't see the clown real clear, you get the paint in the wrong places. I better give you an eyeball test. How many fingers am I holding up?
One.
Two. One, two. Not one. I think you can see close up, but you can't see far away. Let me give you another test. Bend your head backwards and go, ah. I go, ah. Bend your head backwards. Ah. Ah. We gotta fix her right up. I get some seeing glasses. Yeah. Ooh, she's really good with these glasses.
But they're broken. They're broken.
But they're magic, and you can see out of these. Put these right on like this. They're only one way.
No, they aren't.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
But
how many fingers am I holding up? How many fingers?
One.
Good. How about now?
No.
Good. Now bend your head backwards and go, ah. Ah.
Ah.
Ah. Okay, well,
she
that's...
She
already
shot it too,
right? Hi,
John.
How you doing, Jill?
Something gone wrong here today, Jill. It says over here that magician's helper on right. That's you. Should have black curly hair. Well, I don't know what we're gonna do about that. Hold on, let me see what I can do to fix things up for you. Oh, this is not the problem. Yeah! Okay, we're all set now to start the new magic. need some blue. If you're wearing blue, take off the blue and toss it up to me. I need some red. Who's wearing red? I need some white. Who's wearing white? Who's wearing pink? I need some pink. How about some more red? I need some more red, some more white, some more blue, some more red, some more yellow, some more white, some more blue, some more pink, some more white, some more black. That's enough. Mix up all these colors. Oh, yeah. That's enough. Good. Get my paintbrush. Pour all the paint in my paintbrush. Shake your hands. Now clean your hands on your bodice, Mark. How you doing? Is that right? That right? Nice. Jill, I would like for you to take this brush in your hand. And I would like for you to paint the top of the frame. Can you do that? But can you do that from the side so that everyone can see? Paint back and forth. And we have our clown in living color. Thank you. How about a big round of applause for my two volunteers? Thank you, Jill. And thank you, Megan, for being such a good sport. Let me give you a bandana or whatever they call them. What do they call these?
Headbands.
Headbands?
I got one. Headbands.
To conclude our magic show, I'm going to do what no other magician has ever done in the Annals of Magic. You see, any magician can bring with him a live animal. And the magician hides a live animal, and sometimes during the show, he produces it. But today, I'm going to let you decide on the one live animal that you would like Len DeLeo to produce. Now, this animal can be tall, it can be short, it can be fat, it can be skinny, it can be anything that you want. However, I can only produce one live animal per show. To be fair to everyone, I'm going to count to three, and when I say three, you shout out as loud as you can the one live animal that you want Len DeLeo to produce. One, two, three! I got it. I heard all kind of animals. I heard a lion, I heard an elephant, I even heard an orangutan.
A rabbit.
But the very first animal I heard today was a white rabbit. So with your help, we shall produce a white rabbit. I need a magic word. Who knows a magic word?
Please!
Please is a good one. Who knows another magic word? Hocus pocus, who about another one?
Peanut butter and jelly.
How about we use peanut butter and jelly? Let's look inside our magic box. When I say three, you say peanut butter and jelly. One, two, three.
Peanut butter and jelly!
And we have a... Folks, you're not believing in magic. Now to help channel your magical beliefs, I want all of you to go... Let's try that on the count of three. Let's go together. One, two, three. Hi, this is my friend. He just came to join me last week. And this rabbit does not have a name. So if you can think up a name, if you want to send a name to my attention, you can do so, and maybe we can get him, it's a boy, you can do so, and we then have a nice name for this nice rabbit. Well, before we form a nice large circle, so that all of you can pet Fluffy, I've got Fluffy. Fluffy is my other rabbit. Before we have a nice large circle so you can all meet and pet the rabbit, I've got a question. Did all of you enjoy the show today?
Yeah!
Can you show us by giving us a big round of applause? Oh, that's awfully nice of you. That's good. I really had a good time myself. If all of you would form a nice, large circle, a big circle, make it nice and big.
Over there, girls, a big round circle.
A big round circle.
Darren, move back that way. Darren, move back
about 3 feet.
Kevin, move back.
Keep
Megan,
going back.
Back, honey.
I can't move back.
No, you're fine.
We're going to start off with the birthday girl.